Hey everybody, it's your personal trainer, Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia, and this is a lower back and hip exercise routine.
This workout is specifically designed to enhance your mobility, improve your strength, and relieve pain.
There is no equipment that is required for this particular routine, but you may want to use a mat for comfort.
I'm going to be doing the traditional exercises.
And follow me for those easier modifications.
All right, let's begin. So we're going to the ground for the first one. We're both going to be on all fours. We're actually going to do, both of us are going to do the same move for this one. We're going to do a cat-cow. So we're going to, first we're going to bring your stomach and belly button to the floor as you curl your chin up. Bring your chin, raise your chin up to the ceiling. That belly button goes to the floor and your glutes come up and you're just going to hold this position for 15 seconds, making sure to breathe, control your breathing. Good. Now in all these movements that we're doing and stretching today, really want you to take it to the point where you're feeling a stretch, but you still feel comfortable. All right, now we're gonna reverse it. Bring your back up like somebody's pulling the middle of your back from a string and curl your chin into your chest at the same time. Now we're gonna hold here, pulling up on the middle of your back again like somebody has a string, they're just pulling you up. And hold in here for 15 seconds. Again, on all of these, I want you to make this routine your own. If you don't have quite the flexibility that Claudia or I do today, that's okay. Make it your own. Breathe. Okay, let's reverse directions. Opposite, slow transition. Draw that belly button to the floor as you pull your chin up. Good. Breathe. Nice and relaxed. Excellent work. Hold. Good, good, good. Feel that spine stretching. Okay, reverse one more time. Again, pulling up from the center of your back like somebody's pulling you up with a string as you curl that chin into your chest. Excellent. Hold and stretch. Stretch. Good, very good. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, nice. Okay, we're gonna transition into a cobra. So we're coming down into a prone position. Now Claudia is gonna come on her forearms where I'm gonna come all the way up onto my hands. Claudia's is the easier version. I'm gonna curl up with my back flexion, bring that chin to the ceiling and breathe. Again, you decide which one of these versions is right for you and where you're at today. Breathe, 15 seconds and hold. Good. A few big deep breaths. You got it. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and breathe, exhale. We're gonna come back down to a prone position. We're gonna place your arms out in front of you. Now I'm gonna do both legs and Claudia's gonna do one. I'm gonna do a prone leg raise. So I'm bringing both legs off the ground. I'm using my glutes on this one. So squeeze your buttocks either, and Claudia's only gonna bring one leg up at a time. So you decide which one of these two is right for you. Keep your upper body on the ground, just bringing up your legs on this one. If you're doing the one leg version, switch legs. Good. Breathe, squeeze those glutes. You got it. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Nice, rest those legs on the ground. Okay, let's turn over to our backs. We're gonna lie flat on our backs with our feet up. So this next one, we're gonna push our pelvic bone through the floor. Now this one's hard to pick up on camera because you really don't get to see much. We're literally gonna push our pelvic bone through the ground. Keep your lower back flat on the ground and we're just pushing through the ground. So you're pushing straight down with your pelvic bone. Straight down, push down. Good, so this one is gonna engage your core and don't allow your lower back to curve on this one or your lower back to come off the ground. Keep your whole back on the ground while you do this one. Again, just pressing through and breathing. Excellent. Good. Let's hold this one for 5 more seconds. Keep pressing through, straight down into the ground. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Okay, excellent. Relax, shake it out. All right, next we're moving into is an iso hip up. Again, Claudia and I, we're gonna do the same move on this one. Bring your feet nice and close to your glutes. Feet are flat on the ground. Now let's press up, drive up off your heels. And ideally, we want to make a straight line from your knees to your shoulders. So get those glutes up. Don't want to hyperextend, but at the same time, you don't want your butt sagging. So you want a nice straight line. Drive off those heels and really flex your glutes and actually your abs. Even though we are working your back, I don't want you to focus on squeezing your back, but instead focus on hamstrings, glutes, and your abs. Good. And just hold. Excellent work. Again, make this your own. If you can't quite get up as high as we can, that's okay today. Everybody has to start somewhere. You can come back, repeat this routine. You get a little bit better every single time. It's not gonna happen overnight, but if you work at it, I promise you, you will get there. Excellent. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and 0. Slowly back down. Nice. Okay, arms out at our side for the next one. Let's go ahead and bring your knees up to a 90 degree angle. We're gonna do a lying leg twist stretch. So I'm gonna twist my knees all the way down to a 90 where my legs are on the ground.
Stop at a 45 degree angle. So don't go all the way down like Coach Kozak is.
I want you to keep your back flat on the ground while you do this one. So if you don't feel comfortable coming all the way to the 90 with your back flat, then like Claudia is doing on the 45 is great. You choose which one of these two is going to be right for you today. Try to keep those shoulder blades on the ground. Good. Feel that stretch. And if you are doing this full 90, don't just let your body relax. Still keep some tension. Feel that stretch. Good. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Other side. Of course, we got to do both sides. Keep it nice and even. Nice. Good. Now, multiple applications for this routine, whether you just want to do some prehabilitation and strengthen your lower back, or maybe you're trying to fight back from an injury. Either way, this is a great routine for you. Feel that stretch. Good. Hold tight on this one. Again, just take it to the point where you feel comfortable, not to the point where you're in pain. Good. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and back. Nice. Okay, straighten those legs out on this one. Little shake. Okay, next we're gonna do a lying knee to your chest. So we're gonna lying position. We're gonna bring both knees into your chest. Now you might just be right here, or you might be able to get them all the way in. Again, you decide what's right for you today. Come back, and every time you do this, your flexibility and mobility will improve just a little bit. Draw those knees into your chest, pull them in. Nice, excellent work. Breathe. Again, don't feel pressured to match our mobility. You make this workout your routine. Fitness is anything but a one-size-fits-all solution. Make this workout your own. Good. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower your legs back down. Take a second, stretch it out. Okay, next we're gonna do one leg at a time now. So go ahead and bring one knee up, doesn't matter which one. And I want you to try your best to keep that other leg on the ground. So even if it wants to come up, I want you to try to force it to stay on the ground. Excellent. Bring that knee in, again, to the point where you feel comfortable. Getting your back from all angles today. If you have a sciatica, we're loosening it up. Whatever it may be that's ailing you, we're gonna try to hit it today. Good. And 3, 2, 1. All right, let's switch it up. Opposite side now. And pull in. Good. Hold and breathe. So so proud of you today for doing something about this. You know, so many people have an injury or, you know, something wrong with their back, but instead they just get defeated and they, oh, well, I have a lower back problem. That's the way it is. But no, not you. You're taking the steps to make it better. All right. And leg goes back down. Excellent. Okay, next one, we're doing a one leg raise. So go ahead and raise one leg straight. We're going to raise our right leg straight. Try to keep that no bend in that knee. Leg stay out to the side. And just pull back as far as you can on your own. If that looks like this today or like this, that's okay. No big deal.
Then you look like me, and that's all right.
Depending on what workouts we've done this week, our flexibility is going to vary greatly on this one. Depends on how many squats we've done this week. Just keep it straight and just pull. Good. And every time you come back, you're a little bit better at this one. Again, just make this routine your own. All right, and slowly return back to the ground. All right, opposite leg up. Try to keep that leg nice and straight. I know it's hard. I know it hurts. Feel that stretch in your hamstrings, glutes, calves. Excellent. Loosening it up. We're gonna feel so good when this routine is done. All right, almost there. Let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, slowly back down. All right, next we're going to do a knee to the side stretch. So bring one knee up, and we're going to use your hand to gently pull it over to the side. So for this one, you're going to decide what's right for you. This might be enough of a stretch, or you might need to pull it all the way down. But either way, you want to try to keep your shoulder blades flat on the ground, so don't curl and twist with it, but instead keep those shoulder blades on the ground. That'll allow you to get that stretch in your back. You decide if you're here or all the way down. Take it to the point where you feel comfortable today. No reason to push it. This workout's intended to make you feel better. Good. All right, and slowly return. Let's go opposite side. Breathe and stretch. Good. Pull across. Those shoulder blades flat on the ground. Excellent work. Doing great, guys. Keep it up. And let's go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and return. Nice work. We're going to lie down on our back, and we're going to do a lying hip rotation. So go ahead and set that left foot down on the ground. Bring your opposite foot up with your right leg. We're going to take that right hip through the full range of dynamic motion. So we're going to press gently on that knee every time. And every time you can get just a little bit more range of motion. So again, we're going through this 10 times. And throughout all of these movements today, your range of motion may not be what ours is. That's okay. Make it your own. And that 10th time, let's hold. Now hold and press. Feel that hip stretch. And on all these stretches today, I want you to take it to about 85%. So don't take it to the point where it's starting to hurt or stress you, but instead where it just feels like a good stretch. We're holding this for 15 seconds. So let's go 3, 2, 1, and done. Okay, let's switch. Bring that opposite foot up. And again, we're going to go through that dynamic range of motion 10 times. If there's any nerves or tendons that are stuck in your hip, this is a good one to loosen them up. Good. Taking it through that full range of motion. Nice and controlled. Nice and easy 10 times. Breathing throughout. Good. Going a little further every time. 2, 1, and then this last one, and hold. Good. If you need to, you can grab with your opposite side hand and hold this foot in place. And just press. Press on that knee. Feel that hip stretch. Again, aim it for 15 seconds on this one. And we are breathing. Let's go 3, 2, 1,
0. Excellent. Okay, similar position for the next one. Let's go back to that right leg. We're going to do a figure 4. Bring that right leg up. We're going to reach through your legs, both hands wrapped around that knee. Now we're going to pull this knee into. So on this one, we're not doing the dynamic range of movement. We're just pulling and holding for 15 seconds. Now you might be able to pull it all the way to your chest, or you might be good just right here. Everybody's a little bit different. So again, you make this routine your own through your own capabilities today. Breathe, pull, again, feeling that stretch all through your hips and glutes. And 3, 2, 1, excellent. All right, let's bring that opposite leg up and do the left side. Again, pulling to your chest, breathe.
Whew, this side is definitely tighter than my right side.
You know, actually it is on me too, and you might experience that. That's all right, going through these, you might experience and figure out a couple spots are tighter than you had anticipated.
Might discover some new things about yourself during this workout.
Nothing wrong with that. Let's hold for 3, 2, 1, and 0. All right, good. Next, we're going to work on your piriformis, which is up here, this little foramen which your sciatic nerve runs through, often causes that sciatic nerve pain. So we're going to target that one with this next stretch. Go ahead and kick that leg over, your right leg over your left. We're going to angle that left knee in just a little bit. All right, now we're going to grab that right knee with both hands, and we're going to take it through a dynamic range of movement, but we're pulling that right knee to your left shoulder. So you're pulling it across, so not just back, not just over, but you're pulling it up and across and
up towards your shoulder.
Up towards your shoulder. And again, about 10 times through this range of motion. Getting a little bit more of a stretch every time. Working your way into it. 2, 1, and on this last one, 15 second hold. And stretch, good. You feel that stretch all down your leg and into your glutes, maybe a little bit into your back. That's all right, that's how we know it's working. Loosening it up, putting in the work today so that we can feel those results tomorrow. Let's hold for 3, 2, 1, excellent, okay. Gently come back, and let's switch it up. Let's do the opposite side now. Again, I'm gonna angle that right knee in, now my left leg goes over. And let me pull this left knee to my right shoulder. You might find on some of these that you're more flexible than us. Some of them you're less flexible, and that's okay. Everybody is different. Just about doing our best and getting a little bit better every time you come back and repeat this routine. Good, nice controlled breathing throughout. Not using any momentum on this range of motion. Now let's go last one. And let's hold. Pull back. 15 seconds. Feel that stretch. Good. Again, taking that stretch to about 85% of what you're capable of. Maybe 90. But any more than that, and you're really not doing yourself any good. You're just developing scar tissue at that point. So don't take it to the point where it's really hurting. Let's go 3, 2, 1, and done. 0. Good.
We're going to get into a prone position. So we're lying flat on our stomachs. Now I'm going to do a prone Superman where Claudia is going to only do her upper body. I'm doing my whole body. I'm going to place my hands on my head and I'm going to bring both my upper body and my legs up off the ground at the same time. Claudia is only going to bring her upper body off. Now we're doing 12 repetitions. Go ahead and count your own reps and move at a pace that you feel comfortable with. You're squeezing both your glutes and getting a little lower back. Squeeze up at the top. Nice. Good. Breathe. Nice and controlled. No rush. Back down and relax in between. I have 3 more. 2, 1, and zero. Good. Next one, we're gonna straighten out flat. Put my arms out in front of me with my thumbs up. We're both doing the same move. We're gonna do an alternating Superman. So I'm gonna go right arm, left leg comes up, back down. Now left arm, right leg comes up. Good, and you really feel those glutes firing on this one. Again, this was gonna be 12 reps in total, 6 on each side. Good, we're doing 12 repetitions of every movement. Move at a pace that you feel comfortable with. Good. Keep it up. Come back down in between each rep. Raise that arm at the same time. Raise that leg and squeeze those glutes. Good. We're gonna go 4, 3, 2, 1, last one, and 0. Nice work. All right, next we're gonna stand up. Give you a second here to stand up. We're moving into a good morning. Now, I didn't make the name up on this one. Don't ask me why it's called a good morning. We're our feet shoulder width apart. We're gonna place our hands on our head. We're going to start with a little bend in our knee. We're going to keep that same bend throughout the whole move. Now kick your butt back as you bend over using your hips as a hinge until your upper body gets to parallel to the ground. Stand up, bringing your hips forward. Butt back, butt forward. Keep your back straight. Good. That's 3. Butt back. Butt forward. Now, you're going to want to, as you're coming down, you're going to feel instinctively to start bending those knees, but don't do it. Just start that little bend and keep the same bend. So you should be feeling a nice stretch in the back of your legs and in your hamstrings. Let's go 5 more. Good. 4. Back stays straight. 3. And if you can't quite make it this far down, your flexibility isn't there, it's okay if you only get to here and back. That's totally okay. Can't quite make it all the way. Let's go last one and squeeze those glutes at the top. Nice. Okay, we're going back to the ground for the next one. Lying on our backs, we're gonna do a hip up. Hands are at our sides. Bring those feet nice and close to your glutes. Now you're gonna press up off those heels, squeeze your glutes up at the top, and slowly return. 12 reps. Drive off those heels, squeeze your glutes, and back down. Now ideally, at the top position, you have a straight line from your knees all the way to your shoulders. But if you can't quite get your hips up as high as we can today, that's okay. Come back, repeat this workout. You will get a little bit better every time. Now the key on this one is to squeeze your glutes up at the top and not your lower back. So I don't want you to hyperextend your lower back up at the top. Not a race on this one. Let's go ahead and take your time on the way up and on the way down. Nice and controlled. Excellent, guys. Keep up the good work. We're right here with you, rep by rep. Getting a little bit better, feeling a little better every single rep. Let's go 3 more. Almost there. Breathe. Good. 2, 1, 0. From the floor, we're doing a straight leg raise. This is a great one to strengthen your hip flexors. Go ahead and get down on the ground. We're lying down with your left foot flat on the ground. Right leg is straight. Now we're going to bring that right leg to a 45 degree angle and back down. So we're taking it through this full range of motion, keeping your leg nice and straight. Probably gonna feel a little stretch in your hamstring as well, which is totally okay. We're doing 12 repetitions in total. Nice and controlled on this one.
2 more.
1, and on the last one, going into a pulse. So now on that 45 degree angle, we're gonna do 12 little pulses.
10, 11, and 12.
Good, okay, let's switch it up. Hit that opposite side next. Again, leg stays straight. 0 to 45. And we feel that hip flexor working. Trying our best not to bounce your leg or your foot off the ground in between repetitions. If you need to come down and rest in between, you can do so. Almost there.
Two more.
One, and on that last one, let's hit that pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Good. Okay. Moving on to a clam. So we're gonna go to our side for the next one. Bringing our feet together, knees are bent. We're gonna open those hips up and then close them. And again, we're going through that full range of motion, nice and controlled. This one isn't only good for strengthening, but also good for improving mobility at the same time. And at the top, I want you to make sure you contract and flex those glutes. Again, we're using 12 repetitions with 12 pulses. Nice full range of motion, all the way open. Good.
Two more.
And one more, and let's hit those pulses. Just a tight little range of motion. Squeezing those glutes up at the top. Good.
12. Next side.
All right. Let's flip opposite side next. Into position. Feet together. And open them up. Again, taking it through that full range of motion. Try your best to control that negative eccentric lowering phase. You're not just letting your leg flap down, right? But instead, you're staying under control throughout. Excellent work. Breathe. Squeeze those glutes up at the top every time. Strong glutes equal strong hips.
And last one right here.
And into the pulse. Let's hit it. Good. Just a short range of motion. Only these ones are kind of awkward. Doesn't take much.
And last one right here.
All right. Turning back over to our opposite side. We're going to do a lateral side leg raise. So again, lying down on our side, this time with legs straight. Now keeping those legs straight, let's get a full range of motion all the way up, all the way down. And again, controlling that lowering phase, not just letting your leg flap down. Feel that stretch in your inner thigh.
Halfway through this one.
Both your abductors and adductors working on this one. Good. Squeeze those glutes up at the top.
And last one right here, guys.
Into the pulse. Let's hit it. 12 reps. Short, little tight pulses. Excellent. Squeeze those glutes up at the top.
10, 11, and 12.
Nice. All right. Let's hit that opposite side now. One into the next. You're doing great. Keep it up, everybody. Every rep, we're getting a little closer to where we need to be. Getting a little bit stronger. Putting in the work so that we can enjoy those results. Whatever that may be, from pain relief to just a better ability to perform your day-to-day activities.
Last one right here, guys. And move right into the pulses.
You got it. Let's hit those pulses. Whew, I'm liking this one. My right glute likes it.
8, 9, 10, 11, and 12.
Good.
Oh, goodness.
All right, let's turn over onto all fours. We're going to do a donkey kickback. So from all fours, we are going to kick our right heel back. So bring that knee up, kick straight back. Try not to kick the wall behind you like I just did. And then bring it back down to starting position. So up at the top, I want you to straighten that leg, drive that heel back, and in doing so, squeeze your glutes and hamstring up at the top. Again, control that lowering portion of the movement. Don't just let your leg flap down or flail down. Good, drive back, squeeze that heel up at the top.
Two more. 11, and here's the last one coming up.
Let's hit those pulses now. So now the pulses, it's just little mini kickbacks. Just driving that heel back. Push it back, push it back, push it back. Good.
10, 11, and 12. Let's switch legs.
Opposite side now. Let's do it, guys. Doing great. Again,
full range of motion, driving that heel back, and that'll really help you to contract the right muscles and make sure that your glutes are firing on this one. Try best to bring that leg up until it's about parallel with the rest of your body.
Two more.
Last one. And let's hit those pulses right into it. Good. Doesn't take much on these. Drive it back.
10, 11, and 12.
All right, don't go too far from the same position. We're going to do a fire hydrant next. So let's go ahead and bring that knee up out into the side, opening your hip up and back down. So keep that knee bent. Bring that knee straight out to the side. Nice and under control. Again, feeling those glutes work on this one. Try your best not to rotate too much at your hips. Keep your core parallel to the ground. Excellent.
We got four more.
Almost there. Full range of motion. The pulses on this one are my favorite.
And last one right here, guys.
Let's hit those pulses. Ooh, this is when it kicks in. It's okay. It's how we know it's working, everybody. Push through.
10, 11, and 12.
Oh, nice. Okay, last side right here. Again, all the way through. That full, complete range of motion. You got it. And breathe. Keep it under control. Think about what brought you here today to begin with, whatever that is, and recognize that you are working towards that goal. Be proud of yourself every day that you wake up and get a little closer to that goal. Good. Almost there.
Two more.
11.
And last one right
12.
Here, guys.
12. Into the pulses. Let's hit those pulses. Let's go. Come on. Grind them out, guys. Ooh. Burns
Nine,
so good.
10, 11, and your last one right there.
12.
Woo!
All right, nice work. Thank you so much for joining us today. If you like this workout, you've been working out with us for a while, and you're starting to see some results, we'd encourage that you please click the link up top and go check out our Patreon page where you can learn how you can support our mission of keeping these great workouts free.
And if you enjoyed the workout with us today, please click the like button. And we also ask that you please click the subscribe button so that way you're notified every time HASfit drops a new workout.
And make sure you check out HASfit.com for hundreds of free workouts, free meal plans, and our free complete fitness programs.
Also, find us on your favorite social media network, whatever that is. We're on Facebook, Snapchat, Twitter, Instagram.
We're there all day long.
Did I miss one?
I don't know. Reach out and connect with us. Again, thank you so much for working out with us today. I'm Coach Kozak.
And I'm Claudia.
And we will see you at your next workout.